Și dracu faci frate, ți-ar trebui de vopsi?
Vreau să o fac milionar, vreau să vă dau o mulțime de bani. Însă dumneavoastră trebuie să ridicați.
Ești ocupat.
Păi și mie place.
Cine știe încotro mai e? Cine știe cine mai dă decât tine?
Seul à mon mariage s'inscrit dans cette continuité à la fois thématique, de paysage, où on retrouve des éléments voilà, de gens qui rêvent, qui fantasment d'un ailleurs. Et ce rêve est toujours très présent en Roumanie, en tout cas. Les gens ont sans doute besoin de rêver, d'explorer un ailleurs. Et donc j'ai choisi de créer une héroïne, Pamela, qui va au bout de ses rêves. Je voulais une héroïne romanesque, voilà, une fille qui fait plus que le réel, qui va au bout de sa trajectoire. On a fait un casting d'actrice et j'ai choisi tout de suite Alina Sherban. Je n'ai aucune intention militante, démonstrative. Non, je voulais écrire l'histoire d'une jeune héroïne, voilà. Donc, c'est vrai que la condition des jeunes femmes roms dans ces communautés, c'est quelque chose qui me touche. Et cette émotion-là, mais j'ai essayé de la porter dans mon personnage et dans sa trajectoire.
Pamela is just like any other girl. It's just a coincidence she's Roma. This is not the main thing of the story. You have a young girl who finds it hard to negotiate between her own freedom and being a woman and being a mom. Seul à mon mariage, for me, it has a lot of amazing memories, especially because it's filmed in the village where my mom comes from. We were supposed to shoot somewhere else, and that location was not available anymore due to different reasons. I was hearing the discussion. And we were close to this village because we were outside of Bucharest. And I called my mom and I say, "Mom, do we have still relatives in that village?" And she says, "Yes," because she left that village when she was 14. We stopped there and we go to my cousin and I, for the first time, meet Rebecca, the little girl that plays my daughter. And some days after, Marta says, "I want Galbinaș and I want Rebecca to be your daughter." And yeah, it was really out of coincidence. And it was amazing and so heartwarming to go back to the village where my mom comes from, to be surrounded by Roma people there, seeing a Roma woman just like them, and to have kids understanding that they could do what I do too. Both Cassandra, the producer, and Marta listened to me as a Roma. When I said, "I do not believe this. This is not something I recognize in my Roma family." And I was strong about this because, you know, when you are one of the first Roma people to go there in a public image like this of cinema, of theater, even if you want or not, you are representing. And you have a responsibility. And it's just a joyful moment to have a film that I trust, I am comfortable with as a Roma. And I really hope to see many other films this way. And I really hope not to see only just with Roma people, but to see with Black people, to see with gay people, to see with all the diversity. Stories that are not based on their diversity, but they're on their humanity.
Je m'appelle Pamela.
Tu parles français, toi?
Cartable, fenêtre, l'amour, toujours l'amour, Paris, pizza.
We will see amazing humanity at display. And I think this is the ace in the sleeve of the film. Because we don't get to see that humanity so often, no?
Les filles ont besoin qu'on s'intéresse à eux, vous le savez.